keep those stories alive. Phil and I are also keen on doing is we've kept a lot of these machines. These are just the machines, but there's also the history from the people that used to work in the industry.
Put it this way, I've grown up with machines, now I'm looking after them. And that's why I'm here. When the modern technology came through, a lot of it was went out the back door and just sold for scrap, and the new computers came through.
Letterpress printing really is just a combination. It's relief printing, so it's a combination of pressure, ink and paper. The moment you print, you're actually pushing into the paper, and it's very different from modern day contemporary digital printing. I started letterpress printing because I discovered it off the internet. I think seeing a print on screen is very different from actually a printed tangible content. Every paper and every job is slightly different. When you've actually printed it, because it's got deep impression, because the colour is so much more crisp, it comes alive after it's been printed.
It's a really strange combo, the two of us. We're very, very different in personality.
Yeah, no, we get on well. Like me, I admire Anne's ideas, and she relies on me for problems like the printing.
As printers, I think you become a bit of a perfectionist in the craft that you're, like the product you're producing. It's so much better to have a second pair of eyes.
Well, I was always a graphic designer. Gold machinery and stuff has always interested me. So they're all beautiful, simple machines. Browsing through Etsy and I bought a couple of cards and went, I've never heard of this. What is this thing? I think as the printer, I care for it a lot more. But when you get a new design and you get the first print off it and you know you tweak it so that it's printed well and it looks good,
yeah.
That's the fun bit. I still, when I see a beautiful letterpress print, I still think it's amazing. But I ask myself that if I'm 70, am I still going to be doing this?
Letterpressing with a little press, but I've had this big guy for 2 years. I found Big Boy in a garage. He'd been sitting there for like 20 years doing nothing, and I was 25, 26 at the time, so I felt like I'd been sitting there my whole lifetime waiting for me. I need to get a massive truck every time I move it, and I've moved it like 5 times in 3 years, so it's cost me much more. It comes together with like 2 tons of momentum, so I don't think a little desktop printer plastic thing made in China would be able to do that. I guess making things in my hands, definitely. Something tangible. Also wedding invitations, like it means so much to people. Something they'll treasure forever, and they really hold it special. To make beautiful things like that that are really special to people is really nice.
Yeah.
Really rewarding. You just like hand feeding each sheet and you're watching it and you're being patient, letting it do its thing. It's like a meditation, but it's also like a reward for all the patience that it took to set it all up. I think even more so, like the digital age, everything being so on screen, there's something about it, like it's real.
Yeah.
So I think there'll always be a place for that.